Hi, welcome back to Crates with Zed. Today we're taking a look at another video supporter request. This one comes from Raccoon. Thank you, Raccoon, for being a video supporter and enabling me to open up an unlocked cosmetic crate. Today we're looking at the Engineer's Unlocked Cosmetic Crate. This kind of breaks my overlay because there's so many items you can find within it. I have a picture on the right that I stole from a guide. Let me show you the guide. So there's this guide by Toxins and also by Reddit user Tomato Flakes, which is called What You Can and Cannot Find in Keyless Cosmetic Cases. And this has an excellent overview of the things you can find and the things you can't find in each case. The general criteria is it must be a Valve-created cosmetic or have a workshop page, and it can't be limited, retired, can't be from a case, it can't be a craft-only promotional item, and can't be from the Weta workshop, like the Gord. I'll link this guide in the description. This will show you everything in all of the Scout, Soldier, Pyro, Demoman, Heavy, Engineer, Medic, Sniper, Spy, and the multi-class one. Important to note, a mission from these is the Team Captain, which is not a multi-class hat, because it's only on some classes, so it doesn't show up in this multi-class one, which is a bit of a shame. Anyways, you can see the image I stole from the guide on the right, and you can see that they've tagged each unusual item with a little unusual logo at the top right. The reason why Raccoon is wanting me to open up this crate today is because they are in search of the bald cosmetic. They're looking for Texas Slim's Dome Shine with sunbeams as the effect. This is one of the ones you can get from the unlocked cosmetic crate. You can get all those hatless hats with an unusual effect on it. And yes, Raccoon wants to look bald. Something that Raccoon is doing is offering a 400 key bounty for anyone who can unbox this hat. So if we're lucky enough to get it today, we'll be 400 keys richer. And if not, that's a bounty that's open to everyone else in the community. So if you want to help Raccoon out, you can open up some of this crate, but we'll take a look at why you might not want to be opening this crate. Our cost to open is 1.22 keys. That's because we have to pay the full $2.50 through the in-game store if we want to buy this to open. Unlike other crates where we can just buy a key from a site like Mannco.store and pay the cheaper $1.67 US for a key. The expected value for this crate is 0.57 keys, which is a loss of 0.64 keys. That means we're losing half of what we put in when we try to unlock this cosmetic crate. Those are very bad margins. You don't want to be doing this. This is much worse than just gambling at a casino where you'd get 95% of your returns back. This is just throwing your money away, essentially. But it is the only way to get some of these rare unusuals. So maybe it's worth it to you. Not worth it for me. The chance to profit is 9.23%. Most of that's coming from the fact that you can get each of these items in strange or unusual, but some of those stranges are worth some money. We're getting stranges from this crate about 10% of the time, and unusuals at 0.66%. That's like the same as any other crate. The key price at the time of recording is 56.33 refined. The key price in cash is $1.67 US. If you want to buy some keys, or if you want to buy some unlocked cosmetic crates, you can try buying them from Mannco.store. If you use the link in the description and make a purchase of anything on the site, that helps support the channel. Yeah, we can go right to the openings. They'll be pretty uneventful. We'll probably get some unique hats, maybe a couple stranges, and I don't think we can expect an unusual today. That's a 14% chance that we do get an unusual. So I'm not expecting it, but I'm holding out for Raccoon that we can get the bald hat for him. Okay, number one. We don't get the standard unboxing. We get Teddy Robo Belt. Teddy Robo Belt is a craft hat worth 0.03 keys, so we lose the full 1.22 keys we put in. Ouch. Let's go to number two. The Tools of the Trade, another craft hat. Craft belt? Okay, we lose again. Number three. The level three chin. That's one of the better hits at 0.4 keys, but we're still losing almost a full key on that open. Number four. The Scotch Saver. That's worth 0.19 keys. Still a big loss. Number five. Strange Danger. Nice. That's actually a pretty good pull. That's worth 6.42 keys for a profit of 5 keys. So we're up for the video, but we won't stay up for much longer. Number 6. Engineer's Cap. That's another craft hat. Number 7. The Idea Tube. Another craft hat. Number 8. The Flared Frontiersman. Another craft pants. Number 9. Trencher's Topper. Another craft hat. Number 10. The Pocket Purr. Despite it being cute, it's another craft hat. Number 11. Texas Tin Gallon. That's another craft hat. Number 12. Plug-in Prospector. Another craft hat. Number 13. Face Full of Festive. Another craft hat beard thing. Number 14. The Danger. That's not a craft hat, but it's basically a craft hat. At 0.09 keys. Number 15. Lonesome Loafers. 0.03 keys. Number 16. The Timeless Topper. Another craft hat. Number 17. The Data Mining Light. That one's not a craft hat, but might as well be. Number 18. Big Country. That's 0.03 keys. We're losing again. We're down 15 keys so far. We need an unusual to save us, and even then, it probably won't save us. Number 18. 19. Another Big Country. Number 20. The Plug-in Prospector again. Another craft hat. 21. Timeless Topper again. 22. The Pocket Pyro. Another craft hat. 23. Strange Partners Pompadour. That one's worth 2 keys, so we gain a key on that one, but it's not great. Number 24. Pocket Purr again. And our last one. The Texas Half Pants. That's another craft hat. Okay, so another video request, another unsuccessful set of unboxes. We got all craft hats except for Strange Danger and the Partner's Pompadour. Yeah, not a lot to write home about on this one. Our total cost was about 30 keys, and we made back 10 keys, so we did worse than we expected. We expected kind of 15 keys back here. We're losing 20 keys today, but that's okay. We had Raccoon help support the channel with a video supporter membership. And if you'd like to see me open up a specific crate request, you can become a member on my channel and make a video request at that video supporter level. As a reminder, my videos are sponsored by Mannco.store. Mannco.store is an item marketplace to buy and sell TF2 items for cash. And I sell all of my items that I unbox through Mannco.store. So if you want to buy anything from a past trade-up video or a past unboxing, you can check that out here on the link in my description. You can see my entire store of items. I've got a bunch here. Got some unusuals, I got some stranges, so go check it out. We've also got to shout out the Discord and the YouTube membership. So there's a link to my Discord in the description if you want to hang out and chat with other TF2 traders. We're a good, nice, chill community to do that. And for YouTube memberships, we have, at the video supporter level, we have Ghost, Galaxy, Festive Morgan, Minitix, and now Raccoon. Thank you, Raccoon, for this video. At Clan Pride supporters, we have Fortress Demonstrations and NKS Gray. For key supporters, we have Luma JJ, Blue, Afterburnist, Corsho, Penumbra. And for refined supporters, we have Mintai, Joey Cheerio, Basil, Liquid Filth, and Hammock. Thanks everybody, thanks for being part of the community and for supporting my channel. Okay, that's it. Hopefully this is a reminder of why you shouldn't open the Unlocked Cosmetic Crates. This one was the second best one. The best one's the Medic one, but it's not much better. I don't recommend opening any of these here. Unless you want to support Raccoon and it's bouncy. Okay, that's it. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.